and I'm 100% African American. Well, it's, you know, just a beautiful person, and when I mean beautiful, not just physical, but you know, someone's mentally and as well meshes well with me. And you know, obviously everybody's natural and first reaction is to go with looks, you know, but you know, just someone that you really can just bond with and really find a connection to on all levels, you know, physical, mental, and even personality wise, you know, somebody that just meshes well with you. No, I've heard, and it's funny, a lot of my friends can attest, I've dated girls from every spectrum of African-American, black, you know? I've dated every spectrum from extremely high yellow women to, you know, darker skinned women, and I truly don't feel there's a difference. You know, they're all beautiful. Like, the thing I love about being African-American is there's such a wide spectrum of color. You know, a lot of different nationalities and races kind of tend to have the same or kind of prototype to their specific race of a color scheme. Whereas African American, being the beautiful race that we are, we span so far, you know, with such a beautiful prism of just color and diversity. I kind of think it's something that we've been sad disabled. A lot of guys have been seasoned, you know, that way. And it dates back to me and my personal, once again, my personal feelings. It dates back to slavery, you know, in which they had the more fair-skinned people working in-house, and, you know, it seemed that the darker-skinned people seemed to be out more, and they seemed to be very more amongst themselves as to where their slave owners and oppressors just kind of tried to find the closest thing to a Caucasian person, which would be a lighter-skinned African-American, you know? So I think the way to move away from it is break the stigma, you know? Kind of go out and look. Don't have a jaded mind. Don't have a predetermined kind of look in your head. You know, everybody's beautiful, you know, and that's why, once again, I just want to reiterate, African-American, being African-American is so great because there's such a wide spectrum of people, you know, you never know what you'll get.
Now, I don't look for anything specific. I really feel somebody's spirit, before, I think when I was younger, I was pretty shallow. A lot of the women that I know, like, very dark men, well, I don't know. I think there's more appreciation now. I think it was liked before, but there's just even more appreciation now, especially now that you have men who are celebrities who are darker and who are, you know, you have Idris Elba, you have Malik Yuba, you have who's the other guy? Marsh Chestnut. He's the number one I was about to say. Keep all your options open, because it'll be, you know, if you prefer the dark guy or the really yellow girl, you know, you can just as easily get hurt, you know, from the opposite. So just keep your options open and base it off of personality and how you feel when you're around the person and what you pick up from the person. Because I'm just very spiritual and I'm just into that, like, you pick up stuff from people. So, yeah, it's about their spirit.
Okay. Hi, my name is Ashley. I am 25 years old. My parents are Jamaican, but as far as I'm concerned, I'm black. I think what you notice most is their build, if they're athletic or they're your size. So mostly I think once you can kind of spot that they're athletes or they look athletic, that's like the first thing. I don't think that I do consciously, but I think looking back, most of the people I've ever dated for an extended period of time were dark skinned. I don't think I have one consciously. When I meet a guy, I'll be like, oh, you're light skinned, so I'm not going to talk to you. But looking back, of all the people I've dated, all the people I have dated seriously and have been in a lasting relationship with have all been dark skinned. My boyfriend, we've been together for years, and his thing is he's always going to marry a light skinned Jamaican woman. Oh, well, a brown skinned Jamaican woman. So I think for men it might be a little bit more deliberate. Like, they have a type. I want a brown skinned girl with this color eyes or this length hair. But as far as females I do think that some females have a preference. And I think it really just depends what different factors affect what they prefer. Some females date men like the fathers. So I know a lot of people who have dated men that remind them of their dad. I think that despite, you know, this is Jamaica, well, my parents are Jamaican, so I can speak more of what I know. Jamaica's celebrating its 50th year of independence, and even with that, all of the residual effects, or a lot of the psychological residual effects of racism and slavery are very prominent still to this day. Going there, you just see there's a difference if you are light skin, brown skin, dark skin. It shows a representation of how mixed your blood is, and then that is often equated by how your place in society. I'm very disappointed about bleaching. Just looking at a country of black people, that people were still brought up to feel inferior because of their skin complexion. You hear all the time, people are always making comments about skin, and to have, you know, famous reggae artists or prominent people in the community bleaching their skin to be lighter, it's telling about the mentality. Even my own family, of which the females are about the same complexion as myself, when I asked why did you leave the country, they said because they were too dark skinned to get a job.